I saw a film today, oh boy, a good one. I saw a documentary called Louis Armstrong, Black and Blues. And it's a brand new documentary, really superb. I love the movie because it gave me a lot of insight and information about a man that I knew a fair amount about, but I learned a lot more. Louis Armstrong, Sachmo, the great cornet player of the 20th century. And he started out right when the 20th century kicked off, the early 1900s, and jazz was just forming, really, or, you know, it was in its infancy, and he took it to the stratosphere. He influenced music, not just jazz, but popular music across the board from here on out. People had not performed or gotten up and, you know, played their music in the style that he did, being very demonstrative, very excited, smiling a lot, moving around, a lot of action. He basically got into movies too. He was like one of the first superstars, you might say, of pop culture, Louis Armstrong. And the man was fascinating, but this film is, it's really a collage at times, very beautifully done in terms of they have subtitles at times because a little bit of the dialogue's a little bit hard to understand unless you're from the Deep South and you're used to the deep Southern accent, and he speaks in a kind of a colloquial style that, you know, you might miss some of the words otherwise. So I really appreciate they did that. Also, it reveals to us that Louis Armstrong, who was not known for being active in the civil rights movement and going out and carrying a placard and demonstrating and that sort of thing, he preferred to stay behind the scenes and donate money to the cause, make contributions to the cause, because he was deeply concerned. Of course, being a man of African-American heritage, he suffered horrendous, horrendous discrimination and prejudice and bigotry throughout his life. I mean, there were hotels he would play to, mostly white audiences, and he could not stay in the hotel. And the thing is, people asked, well, why didn't Louis Armstrong boycott that and refuse to do that? Well, look at it, folks. He was from a time when you needed to try to fit into society to make something of yourself financially. And he always had. He'd been a little bit of a hustler, not a dishonest man at all, but a hustler who was ambitious. He was out there working and doing things to try to make a dollar. And he did. He made a good bit of money, although he was cheated by the record companies, just like so many artists were, especially black artists of that time. And Louis Armstrong just kept persevering, kept pushing ahead. And he basically, he had a conflict, you can tell, and that comes out in the movie, because what we get to listen to are a lot of audio tapes that he recorded. He had a huge, massive audio tape recording, reel-to-reel tapes, thousands of them that he compiled, a lot of just people talking, him having conversations with people. And so we get to actually hear firsthand what the man was all about. And he was a very deep man in terms of his thoughts and his emotions and his convictions about, you know, basically black people had been discriminated and treated poorly. Poorly is an understatement, but had really been, you know, just treated like not even citizens, like third class citizens in America for so long, especially in the South. And here was a time where he was able to have a little bit of influence to try to bridge the gap between white and black America at the time. And he did that as being a sort of an ambassador, as they say in the movie. He was an ambassador in that he played for white audiences. He had white other musicians he played with. He promoted harmony and peace relations, good relations between people of different colors, as if to say, it doesn't matter. It doesn't even mean anything. We're all people. We ought to appreciate our differences, that some of us are light and some of us are dark skinned, but it doesn't matter. And so he never fed into the idea that this racial inequality and horrendous system that we had, that it just totally discriminated against black people, he didn't rail out against it vocally. And whether he, at the very end, had that on his conscience or not, I don't know. It didn't seem like that he did. It seemed like that he lived a life of quality. He enjoyed his life all the way. He shared everything he had with people. He was so down to earth, they say, that he would sometimes just be in a group of people and you wouldn't know he was the superstar that he was. He was just a sweet man who cared about people, children, men, women alike, all people of all ages, races, colors, whatever, backgrounds. Sachmo was just a real, real sweet man who was gifted and you might say a genius. And I really love the movie. Of course, you get to hear a lot of great music by him in the movie too. So thumbs up for Louis Armstrong, Black and Blues.